In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a rock and roll song with GarageBand. This is a beginner's video to really just show GarageBand and the functionality to those who have not seen it before, so I'm not going to create a whole song or any type of advanced songwriting or features. So let's go ahead and take a look now. If we click Empty Project in the main GarageBand window and click Choose, you will see when GarageBand pops up that it's going to ask me for the type of audio that I want to use. I can use a drummer track, I can use a guitar, a microphone, or even one of GarageBand's built-in software instruments. To lay down this rock and roll song, let's just go ahead and select drummer and click Create. Once that opens, you can see a drummer track has been added, and at the bottom, we see the drummer editor, and to the left, the library and the drum kit that we're using. If you do not see these, hit one of the buttons at the top. The first one is library, and the last one is for the editor. Let's go ahead and maximize GarageBand so we can use the full screen. And we can hear how this sounds. All right, so that sounds good. Now, the first thing we want to do is check our tempo, our key signature, and our time signature. The tempo is fine, we'll stick with 120 beats per minute, but we do want to change this key signature to E major. That is the key that we're going to be playing in, and we're going to use a 4/4 time signature, which is pretty basic with rock and roll songs. I also want to loop just a section of this drum track and lay our parts over that. So I'm going to click the cycle button here, and you'll see a yellow bar pop up. Now I can stretch or squash this to however long I want it to be, but 4 bars is good. So we're just going to hit play, and it'll play those 4 bars over and over again. So as you can see, when it gets to the end, it's going to cycle back to the beginning, and I can lay my parts over that. Now, if I want to change the drum style, I can go to the drummer editor at the bottom, and I can change it to rock, alternative, songwriter, R&B, electronic, and hip-hop. We're going to stick with rock, and we're going to keep using Logan, and we'll just use the drums that they have. Let's go ahead and play this and mess around with some of the settings. And you can see the XY pad here, and based on where I move this, you can hear changes within the drums. I can make it more complex. I can make it simple and loud. I can make it soft and complex. Let's go ahead and move it to about the middle, maybe a little more complex. And I can even change what types of drums he's playing on. So I can select the cymbals, the toms, but we'll stick with the hi-hat for now. I can also change the styles that they're playing, the fills, and a swing beat if I would like to add that, but I think this is good. So we'll go ahead and stop that. Now we want to add in a bass part. To do that, we need a new track, so we're going to click the New Track button, and this time we're going to select Software Instrument and click Create. When it first comes up, we're going to have a classic electric piano, but we want this to be a bass. First, we need to hear how it sounds. So go to the top menu bar, select Window, Show Musical Typing. And this is going to bring up a keyboard that I can use based on the keys of my computer. So if I hit notes on the computer, you can hear it actually play back on the keys. And of course, these are the letters of the keyboard on the computer, not the actual notes of a real keyboard. So if I hit the A button on my computer, it's going to play a C note. Let's go ahead and get a bass sound. So we'll go to the library, we'll click Bass, and select Liverpool Bass. Now when I play, you can hear a bass sound. All right, that sounds good. And we want to record with this bass sound, and we're just going to use some basic chords that you hear in most common rock and roll songs. That's going to be an E, a B, a C sharp, and then an A. So we're going to record, but first we want to count in a couple beats so that we actually know when to start. Right now, the count and timer is selected, and it's going to give us one bar. Let's go ahead and change it to 2 bars by going to the menu bar, clicking record, count in, and 2 bars. This will give us 2 full bars of clicks before we start playing so that we can just kind of get our hands set up on this keyboard. All right, we'll stop that, rewind, and we'll listen to it. All right, that sounds really good. Now, when we are using a software instrument, we are creating MIDI notes essentially, and that's what these bars are. And we can see that it's a MIDI region because it's green. If we look down at the bottom, our editor has changed to the piano roll editor, where we can actually edit these notes. So I can select and grab them, and I can move them up and down for different notes, and I can move them left and right based on their timing. Move it back down to where it was. And let's say that we were off a little bit on one of these notes. So we're just going to shift that to where it's not landing up on the beat. As you can see by this line right here, it's coming in a little bit before. GarageBand has an awesome feature where we can actually quantize the notes, which means we're going to align them up to the beat automatically. So go over to Time Quantize, and we're going to select 8th note, and it's going to push all the notes to its closest 8th note. And when I do that, you can see that these notes line up on the beat, and every note in here has adjusted to its closest 8th note counterpart. So let's hear how that sounds now. All right, that sounds really good. So now that we have the bass part, we need to have a guitar part. So we're going to add another track. Now we could plug in a guitar or an amp at this time, but I do not have any instruments hooked up because I just want to show you the basics of this software. So we'll go ahead and click Software Instrument again and hit Create. And this time, we are going to go over to guitar and choose a hard rock sound. And we can hear how that sounds. Now, if we want to change the sound later, we can very easily within GarageBand. But let's go ahead and record so that we can see how it sounds. And we're just going to use the same notes. This time we'll add the fifth of every chord so that we can have a little more of a power chord sound. Let's go ahead and record. All right, we're going to back up and we'll listen to that. Okay, so we want to quantize these again because as you can see, I came in a little early based on the beat. So we'll click Time Quantize and we'll select 8th note. And we've moved everything to the closest 8th note. Let's listen one more time. Now these notes in the piano roll editor are able to be edited, made longer, shorter, moved around, cut up, however you want. If, say, these are a little short, I can select them, click this option, and then just move them out a little bit so it makes those notes longer. As you can see, these two aren't lining up, but sometimes I like to keep them a little off so it sounds a little more natural. You don't want it to sound too mechanical by always being right on the beat. But now we have our guitar sound. Let's close the musical typing, and we are going to mess around with the actual audio quality of that guitar instrument. So we're going to go to the top, and then we're going to close the library. As you can see at the bottom, we have controls for this actual guitar sound. Let's play and listen, and we will adjust these sounds as we go to trying to get the quality that we're looking for. I'm going to turn up the drive here. You can hear it change. Let's add a little reverb. Maybe too much there. All right. We'll stop that. And that's a really cool sound for what we're looking for. Now, say I want to adjust it a little more, I'm going to click on the Show Inspector button in the bottom left, and you can see some plugins being used on this guitar. If I drop that menu down, you can see that we have a pedal board and an amp designer. If I click Amp Designer, you can see the amp being used for this guitar sound, and even the mic and mic placement of that guitar cabinet. We can change all these settings to get exactly the sound and tone we're looking for, and GarageBand has a lot of presets that you can look through. So this is a great way to get different kinds of sounds and even experiment if you don't have these amps with maybe some sounds that you want to play live. Let's go ahead and close this, and we're going to click on the pedal board. And let's add a pedal to this guitar track. Now we don't want the flanger, so I'm going to just click on it and hit delete. And you can see that the smart controls change based on what kind of pedals and amps I'm using. We'll go back up to the pedal designer and we'll just bring in a distortion. And we'll play and hear how that sounds. Turn down a little bit. All right, very cool, I like that. So we'll stop that. So now we got the sound that we're looking for. And from here, you could basically add another track, and I could record a vocal track with the microphone at this time if I wanted to. Let's take a look at some other things that you can do with GarageBand. There's also an EQ setting, so I can go ahead and adjust the EQ of this track if I want to. And I can also go up to the editors. And when I go up, you can see that we have the piano roll editor, and we also have the score editor. The score editor is going to let you see music in actual written form, so let's click on it. Now we played these notes with our keys, but it actually wrote out the notes musically, so we could print this out if we wanted to share this with others. You can see that we have the clef, the key signature, the time signature, and the notes we play. If you click on notes, you can actually insert notes, so you could even write music based on the score, and it would show in the MIDI regions and playback with the software, instrument, and effects that you're using. Let's play it so you can look at it real quick. And if I click on the bass, you can see the bass part. And there you have it. Let's look at a couple other things. Of course, we've got our playback controls at the top that we've been using, our LCD screen showing this the beats and divisions and ticks and key signatures and time signatures. You see the cycle button that we're using, the tuner. We have a count in and a click track if we want to use that. This is our master volume. We also have a notepad if we want to write down some lyrics or notes for the song. Let's look at the last one, which is a media browser. And this is if I actually have my own audio files that I want to drag in, whether they be loops or audio that I've recorded in the past. And the middle one is the Apple Loops browser. And these are a bunch of repeatable loops that Apple provides for you to use within your projects. And they are based on scale, on type of sound, genre, or even the instrument. Let's click on tambourine. And if we click one time, we can listen to this first one. All right, so we like that. Let's go ahead and click and drag that into the tracks area. Now you can see that it's highlighted in blue, showing that it's audio waveform. And whenever we look at the editor at the bottom of this track, it's the audio editor, not the piano roll editor. Now of course, this isn't long enough to fill the four bars, so we need to copy this over. We'll just hold the Alt key and click and drag that over and add another section of tambourine. Let's hear how that sounds. All right, and there you have it, the very basics of a rock and roll song within GarageBand. Here I could keep adding instruments, I could play live instruments through the computer, I can cut and paste, so if this was, say, the verse, I could easily copy and paste all this into another verse later on after I've written the chorus, and you can just keep adding from here. So GarageBand is a very awesome, versatile piece of software that you can use to quickly get in here and make some awesome, cool arrangements. Now, whenever I'm done, I can go to the top, click share, and I can share this with iTunes, SoundCloud, or even export this song into an audio file for later use. So I hope you found this very valuable. If you have any questions, feel free to contact me, and I look forward to seeing you more in other videos. Thanks.